Welcome to Modular Classroom. In Artificial Intelligence series, Statistical Reasoning, today we are going to see about certainty factors and rule-based systems. As we saw in the previous class, Bayes' theorem is a probability-based reasoning method that is used for handling uncertainty. But to apply Bayes' theorem, the user needs an estimate of a priority and a conditional probability, which is very difficult to calculate in some domains. So for that, one practical way of compromising a pure Bayesian system is to adapt certainty factors. It is an alternative to Bayesian reasoning system. So what is a certainty factor? CF, in a short form, it is a number to measure the expert's belief. The maximum value of the CF is plus 1, that is a positive 1 means definitely it is true, and if it is minimum, negative 1 means definitely it is false. For example, if the expert states that some evidence is almost certainly true, a CF value will be 0.8, so that you can make an assignment to that particular evidence very strongly. So this CF approach was developed in the Meissen system. Meissen is nothing but it is an expert system. It attempts to recommend appropriate therapies for patients with bacterial infections. It interacts with the physician to acquire the clinical data it needs, and it uses the LISP structure, and it represents most of the diagnostic knowledge as a set of rules. So diagnostic is being done based on that some rules that is being stored in the knowledge base. So associated with each rule is a certainty factor. As already said, certainty factor is nothing but it is a measure of the belief or disbelief on a conclusion in the presence of a set of evidence. So in expert system with CF, the knowledge base consists of a set of rules that have the syntax like if evidence, then hypothesis, given then hypothesis supported by the CF value. This is where the CF represents the belief in hypothesis H given that evidence E has occurred. So a typical Meissen rule will look like if the stain of the organism is gram positive and the morphology of the organism is coccus and the growth of conformation of the organism is clumps. If these are the evidence, then the hypothesis is there is a suggestive evidence 0.7 that the identity of the organism is staphylococcus. This form says that the role of the user is represented internally and it is an easy to manipulate in the LISP structure. Here the CF value is 0.7. So it is a supporting evidence. Likewise, the CF factor is used to match the uninterpreted ways in many. The CF factor, if it is of value minus 1.0 to plus 1.0, intermediately, if it is 0.4, means the value term it is being notated as maybe not. If it is positive 0.4, means it is maybe. Likewise, from positive 1 to negative 1, it is the CF factor is used to denote the supporting evidence. So internal LISP structure looks like the premise and the action. This is the syntax that is followed in the LISP, in premise and in the action. For the same example that we saw in the previous slide, context is gram positive and morphococcus, and the context is same, you confirm it is a clumps. There is a bacterial infection that has been affected as staphylococcus, and the CF supporting value is 0.7. So like this, Meissen uses to reason backward to the clinical data available from its goal of finding disease, that is organism, bacterial organism. It selects a therapy by which the disease may be treated. So what do these CF mean? That a certainty factor is defined in terms of two components. One is MB, measure of belief, and another one is measure of disbelief, MD. The values of MB and MD range between 0 and 1. The strength of belief or disbelief and hypothesis H depends on the kind of evidence E observed. Some facts may increase the strength of belief, but some increase the strength of disbelief. So, measure of belief is, it is a measure between 0 and 1 of belief in hypothesis H given the evidence E. It measures the extent to which the evidence supports the hypothesis. It is 0 if the evidence fails to support the hypothesis. Measure of disbelief, it is also lie between 0 and 1. it extends to which the evidence supports the negation of the hypothesis, and it is zero if the evidence supports the hypothesis. So by using these two, certainty factor is calculated as CF is equal to MB minus MD given the hypothesis, given the evidence E. So the CF given is a certainty factor, the hypothesis H due to evidence E, MB is the measure of increased belief, and MD is the measure of increased disbelief in H due to E. So two important things, one is evidence E and another hypothesis H. So it gives a conclusion. It is possible for related evidences giving rise to a hypothesis or conclusion. So the value of the CF is determined by the domain expert who creates a knowledge base. We're going to see about combining certain rules of three concepts. One is, first diagram shows several rules that provides evidence that relate to a hypothesis. Second diagram shows belief as a collection of several propositions. And third diagram shows output of one rule provides input to another rule. So combining these factors, you must satisfy some properties. The first property is order of evidence is collection is arbitrary. Second, until certainty is reached, confirming evidence should increase MB. Disconfirming evidence should increase MD. The third point is, if uncertain inferences are chained together, then the result should be less certain. So taking the scenario from the first figure, the measure of belief formula is given and the measure of disbelief formula is given. As you see, measure of belief is equal to 0 if measure of disbelief is 1. And measure of disbelief is equal to 0 if measure of belief is equal to 1. From given that MB and MD, CF can be computed. Several sources of confirming evidences are put, the absolute value of CF will increase. If conflicting evidences are introduced, the absolute value of CF will decrease. This is an example given. Initial observation is MB is equal to 0.3, disbelief is equal to 0, and CF is equal to 0.3. Second observation is 0.2. By applying this formula, you just get the CF is equal to 0.44. So, slight confirmatory evidence if you produce, it will increase the larger the certainty factor. So measure of belief supports the evidence, CF value will be increased. Second scenario, the formula is used with the conjunction and disjunction of the two hypotheses. The formula is this. And this is the scenario that is taken in the C figure. Rules are chained together with the result that the uncertain outcome of one rule must provide the input to another. So from this, the C of the hypothesis must take both the strength with which evidence suggests the hypothesis and the level of confidence in the evidence. This is the chaining rule formula given in the Meissen. So as an example, if you take, if there is enough fuel in the vehicle and the ignition system is working correctly and the vehicle does not start, then the fault lies in the fuel flow. That certainty factor is 0.75. The above methods are used by Meissen for certainty factor calculation. That is, if the CF value of 0.75 is assigned by the domain expert on the assumption that every if part is known with 100% certainty. But if the if part is not known with 100% certainty, then the above formula should be used. Like these methods, only the Meissen is used for calculating CF. Meissen works because each CF in the Meissen rule represents a contribution of an individual rule. It represents a conditional probability, but in pure Bayesian system, it is considered only with the relevant evidence. If there are other evidence and joint probabilities need to be considered. But in Meissen, all the combinations that make the assumption that rules are independent. Another example, when independence assumptions are violated, the situation goes like this. For example, S means spring cover was on last night, W grass wet. If the sprinkler was on last night, then that is suggestive evidence that the grass will be wet in this morning. And the second rule, if the grass is wet this morning, then that is suggestive evidence it rained last night. Sprinkler on means there is evidence for the grass to be wet is 0.9. And if the grass is wet in this morning means evidence is 0.8 to support that it may rain, that may be rained in the last night. And this rule makes sense when rain, the water is the most common source on grass. But if these two rules are applied together, that comes the rule for chaining. You're just going to multiply 0.8 and 0.9. That gives 0.72. That is, sprinklers suggest wet and wet suggest rain. Both CF values have been multiplied together, and it is believed that it rained because it is believed that the sprinkler was on. One of the major merit of Meissen rule system is to allow consider individual antecedent consequent relationship independently of others. So the CF and rule based system approach makes strong independence assumptions that make easy to use. Also, assumptions create dangers if rules are not written carefully. Thank you for watching.